Now we are doing a very important topic, that is electrostatic induction. I want to understand one or two things beforehand. Number one, we take any material, it has got negative charges as well as positive charges. These negative and positive charges, how does it acquire? Okay, we have learned that in the atom, the net charge is zero. In the atom, whatever are the charges at nucleus, the same numbers are there for electrons, and we find the net charge is zero and electrons are moving around it, and this material as a whole has zero charge. Then does this material has charge? No. If I want to put a charge, then from where do I get it? There is no charge. All atoms are zero charge. So, I want to tell you one thing, that this situation is when the temperature of a body is zero. And what zero? Kelvin. And how much is zero Kelvin? Minus 273 degree Celsius. If it is such a cold temperature, these are having energy. With that energy, only that much energy that it can rotate. If energy is more than that, then what will happen? If energy is more than that, then when they are rotating around this and energy increases, they go like this and they go out. Once this electron goes out at high temperature, high temperature is what? Room temperature. Because room temperature is how much? Let us say 27 Celsius. 27 degrees Celsius is plus 300 Kelvin. So from 0 Kelvin to 300 Kelvin is lot of increase in the temperature. If this is increase in the temperature, then there is lot of energy given to this electron, and maybe some electrons will leave the orbit work and will go out. Now when they go out, we get, in place of one box, we get two boxes, two particles. This particle has got one electron less, so this we will give positive charge particle, and this electron is another entity, this is negatively charged particle. So now in this body we have one positive charged particle, one negatively charged particle. Basically they are produced by an atom which was having zero charge. So how much is net charge of a material? Answer, net charge of a material is still zero. But in this there are few particles which are positively charged and there are few particles which are negatively charged. So in any body it happens, this number may be more, less, very less, but there are certainly certain negative charges and certain positive charges. This is the condition mostly for metals. For insulators we can say that this does not happen, but for metal, this is happening, and we get lot many positive charges, lot many negative particles separated, move around. But these negative particles cannot come out of this surface, because moment they go out, rest of the material will become positive and it will attract it back immediately. So now we have this one body, it has got lot many positively charged particles and many negatively charged particles. How many? Answer is equal in numbers, because the net charge of this is zero. But even the net charge is zero, there are separate particles, positive and negative, that I have explained you, which are formed at the higher temperature. Okay. All these electrons, negatively charged, keep on moving here and there, and they are spending time here, 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 everywhere. They are spending time. Now, I do one operation. I charge a glass and that glass rod I keep here. This glass rod has got certain excess positive charges. What is excess positive charges? Now you know. It has lost certain electrons, so the number of positive charges are more, so it has got more positive charges. Let us say we are not showing the neutral atoms, we are not showing the electrons, we are showing only excess charges, which are positive charges in this case. Okay, this is positively charged. It has got all type of charges and all these charges are distributed all over the material. The moment we put it close, all these positive charges according to their nature attract negative charges. And according to their nature, they will repel similar charges which are positive charges. So positive charges are repelled, negative charges are attracted. And what we see, all these electrons are moving very rapidly here and there. They are spending their time all over. But suddenly we find many of the electrons, majority of the electrons spend their more time in this corner. And more of the positive charges spend their time on this corner. Why? The positive repel positive and the positive attract negative. And now we find it this way. This is our positive glass which has got excess of positive charges. And what we find here, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, all these are there. But in this one corner, negative, and in this one corner, there are positive charges, excess. So this is what we have all around. Not effect on all the charges, but electron, that is negative charges, try to spend their more time on this corner, and positive charges try to spend their time on this corner because of this repulsion on positive. This is repulsion and this is attraction. So this is what happens. Now we can say that these were the charges mixed, positive, negative here, like this. Once we have put this positive here, what has happened? All these plus, minus, and they were like this. Now, the moment we put this positive and they become like this. These are negative charges, these are positive charges. Rest are there. So, negative go to one corner, positive go to one corner. In general language, what do we call this phenomena? We call this phenomena polarization. Polarization, the particles of different nature going to different corners. Like in our class we say boys will sit on one side, girls on one side. So there is a polarization. You want a holiday on Thursday or Friday. Half of the people say Thursday, half of the say Friday. So our thought is, our decision is polarized. So whenever there is a separation, there is polarization. Now here, there is polarization of charges, electrical charges. Why it has happened? Because there is a charged material which is brought near to an uncharged material. Yes. It was like this. When we bring it here, then they get polarized. When the charges get polarized, this incidence, we call it electrical or electrostatic induction. Electrostatic induction. So, is there any touch between them? No. It has applied the force without touching. Whenever we do a job without touching something, then we have done induction. Remember the word induction. Induction is doing a job without touching. Without touching or without making a contact. Then we say induction. Okay. So, the charges are brought to one side without touching them. So this is electrostatic induction. We can write one line definition of it. Okay, this is electrostatic induction. When a charged body is brought near an uncharged conductor, the free charges in the conductor gets polarized. This phenomena is electrostatic induction. What is the result of this electrostatic induction? Now you see this positive, this is negative, there is a force of attraction. This positive and this positive, there is a force of repulsion. Now, can you tell me what will happen to this body? Will it get attracted towards this or will it get repelled by it? The charges are equal. Yes. The answer is it will get attracted. Why it will get attracted while the charges are same? The answer is the force of attraction is between these two charges and this distance is less. So the force is very large and this distance is large. So the force of repulsion is smaller. Therefore, attraction force is larger, this will get attracted. Okay, was this body a charged body? No, this is an uncharged body. So this is a charged body. Now there is a basic fundamental question. Can a charged body apply a force on uncharged body? There are two answers, yes and no. Yes, because this is an uncharged body, it has attracted it. This you have seen when I show you the pieces of paper which were uncharged. This I made charge, put it here, it was attracted. So uncharged body, so charged body can apply force on every body, even if it is uncharged body, it can apply. But if you go very minutely, why it has applied force on it? Because this portion, this one body has become a charged body. So it has applied force of attraction. This body has become a charged body. So it has applied a force of repulsion. But this force being stronger, the net result was attraction. So basically, there is a force between charge to charge. It so happened that these two charges are in the same body and we say it is a neutral body. So in our general language, we remember, in a neutral body, when we bring a charged body to it, two things happen simultaneously. Number one, this is what? Induction. And just after induction, we say there is a attraction because this force is stronger. So, we have a very famous sentence in electrostatics that there is always an induction before attraction. Because if these negative charges are not here and plus are not away, then these two forces will be equal. Why these forces of attraction are more? Because they are closer, because there had been an induction earlier. So, induction. Precedes attraction. So, whenever you are attracted, first there has to be induction. Then only there will be attraction. Remember that. Okay? So, this is what happens whenever there is a attraction. Attraction cannot happen without induction. Okay? So, next class we will study that how we charge a body, what are the different methods, and there are very interesting methods, 2 or 3 methods, we will study that.